Hello, everyone. Thank you for viewing. My name is Benard Wabusa. I am greatly privileged and honored to minister and share with you the message today under the theme, Running Your Race in Your Lane. As we are all aware, the world is full of breaking news. And as it says, really, some of this news come to us indeed to break us down, to discourage us. Some of it come in order to make us lose hope. But today, we come to you with the great news, and which is the good news. And the only good news that we have is the news about Jesus Christ. Before we go into our text today, let us humble ourselves and we pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we appreciate you for yet another great opportunity you have given unto us. We know that this is the day that you have made for us to rejoice and be glad. Father, I pray for the viewers out there, King of Glory, that you use my voice as your mouthpiece to deliver the message that you have for each one of them. And at the end of it all the glory and honor will come unto you. So, viewers out there, quickly open with me in the book of First Corinthians chapter 9 and verse 24, 25, 26, and 27. As we study about the life of Paul, and verse 24, the Bible says that, do you not know that those who run in a race all run, but one receives the prize? Run in such a way that you may obtain it. And everyone who competes for the prize is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a perishable crown, but we for an imperishable crown. Therefore, I run thus, not with uncertainty. Thus I fight not as one who beats the air, but I discipline my body and bring it into subjection, lest when I have preached to others, I myself should become disqualified. Viewers out there, there are a number of races on earth here. And the life that we live is likened to a race. For example, those that are married, there is a married race. For those that could be still single, probably there is a singles race. Those that are in business, it could be a business race. What about those that have children and they are parents? Probably it is a parenting race. What about work? Maybe it is also a race. And ministry that God has given unto you, if you consider it as a race, you'll be able to run to the finishing line. But one sure thing I know is that even if all of us, we are running this race, the race might be a similar race, but one thing I'm sure that each one of us has been demarcated for a special lane that you are supposed to run in, and your crown awaits you at the end of the race, not at the beginning of the race. No one is ever crowned at the beginning. Many times when we run and we are not running in our race, we are not running in our lane, we might run very well and finish. But if you do not finish it in your own lane, you might miss out the crown. So why is it important for us to run in our own lanes? Number one, it helps us to focus on our divine purpose. God did not make any mistake by creating you and placing you on earth here to be like another person. Yes, there are instances where we come and then we want to be like other people. But just imagine the whole world, over 7.7 billion people that are living on Earth here, none of them looks like you. That means that you are a special person who has been designed to accomplish a special purpose. Now, this purpose in your life, you cannot delegate it to any other person. If you do not accomplish what God has made you to do on earth here, that means there will be a vacant space in that purpose of yours. So, that's why when our Lord Jesus Christ came, the Jews wanted to arrest him and make him their king, make him their leader. But that was not his purpose. He had to make sure that he comes and he accomplishes the purpose that God sent him on earth here. Really, somebody out there, God has designed you for a special purpose. Now, you cannot identify this special purpose if you are running in the lane which is not yours. It can only be discovered when you get stuck in your lane until the end. All the blessings that you want in your life, they are specifically placed along your lane, not in other person's lane. Point number two, when we focus and we remain in our lane, it helps us to focus on the divine purpose, on the divine prize, not focusing on the people that we are running with. Why? Verse 24, as we've just read the text, verse 24, part B says that, run in such a way as to get the prize. Friends, do not run this race just for the sake of running. Run with the mindset of, at the end of it all, you have a prize that you are getting, because that is the most important thing in our lives. This explains why Paul, in verse 27, he clearly says that, I discipline myself so that when I've preached to others, I myself, I am not found disqualified. Really, really, you can be able to do whatever that you are doing out there. But I want you to pause a little bit. Are you doing out of disqualification, or you are doing it within the qualification? Because there is a possibility that you can run and run and run, but you are doing a miss. In Philippians chapter 3 and verse 14, still Paul states and says that, I press toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Jesus Christ. The life of salvation that we are in today is a life of pressing on. I know where you are, there could be a number of things that want to push you down. But today, through the Spirit of the Lord, we've come to encourage you. I've come to encourage you that you need to press on. Those that want to give up in your business, press on. Those that want to give up parenting, please don't give up. Press on. Those that want to give up work because there is a lot of pressure, please do not give up. Press on towards the end, because the prize awaits you at the end of it all. How will it be said when Jesus Christ looks at you one day, you've gone home, and then looks at you and speaks the words that are recorded in Matthew chapter 7, verse 23, specifically 23, that I don't know you. Even when you've said, I cast out demons in your name, I did whatever I did in your name, and Jesus says, I don't know you. How will it be? Please, viewers out there, press on to reach the final mark and the final goal. Number three is, when you run and you remain in your lane, you inspire others. There are people out there that are looking up to you. There are people that are looking up to your marriage. They are looking up to you, the way you are doing your ministry. the way you are doing your work, the way you are carrying out your business, the way you behave, and they are, you are inspiring them to do the same. And the moment you do not remain in your own lane, there are very many people that you're pulling down. There are many people that you are discouraging, and you're doing a disservice out there. So I encourage you today that as you leave, you need to leave knowing that you are an open letter. The people who are reading you, wherever you go, there are those who are wishing and those who are looking at you, and you are the inspiration in their lives. Paul says clearly in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 1, he says, imitate me as I imitate Christ. As you are there, as you look at yourself, as I look at myself, can we come out openly? Can you come out openly and tell people that imitate me? What are people going to imitate about you? What are they going to look at you and they surely say, yes, this is the right path we have started. So child of God out there, as we think about the things of running our race, but running it in our own lane, know that your prize awaits you when you complete the race. As I conclude, I want us to look at the quote from a man called Rumi. He quoted and said that it is your road and your road alone. Others may walk with you, but no one can walk it for you. It is your race, and it is your race alone. Others can run with you, but no one can run it for you. How I pray that as we meditate upon these words, one time we shall also quote what Timothy quoted, what Paul quoted to Timothy as he was concluding his ministry in 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 7, where he said that, I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Let those three things be our key in our lives as we run the race. Fight a good fight, finish the race, but also keep the faith. May God bless you all.